With the upcoming launch of Relfydess, the new form of botulinum toxin from Galderma, launching this summer in the UK, many of us have been asking, what are the benefits? Is there a significant improvement in maybe the onset of action, in the duration, in the longevity, in the immunogenicity of this product? Are these scientific findings real? And what are the clinical experiences? What I'm going to do today is try to share with you, in my opinion, looking at the evidence and the data, what are the benefits, if at all? So stay tuned and please subscribe to our channel for further updates. I'm Dr. Ravi Jain, owner of Riverbanks Clinic, wellness and aesthetic practice in Harpenden, and I'm lucky enough to have been an educator globally, and I'm producing this video to help aesthetic practitioners understand, is Relfydess what it's all cracked up to be? So the first thing to recognize is that Relfydess is a botulinum toxin type A. It is RELA botulinum toxin, and it has been identified and created by the originators of Restylane. This journey started 15 years ago, and at the time wanted was a faster acting, longer lasting, and cleaner, purer botulinum toxin. And they identified a new strain of botulinum toxin in Poland. This is important to understand. All the currently available botulinum toxin type A's that are used aesthetically come from what's known as the Hall strain of botulinum toxin type A. So Botox, Dysport, Azulur, Xeomin, Eucevia, etc. They are all from the Hall strain of botulinum toxin type A. And the differences between each and every one of these proprietary brands is the manufacturing process. How is that botulinum toxin type A taken from the Hall strain and delivered to you in clinic? There's a lot of talk about complexin proteins that stabilize the active neurotoxin. There's a lot of benefits maybe to having some liquid-only toxins, as with Eluzience from the ABO botulinum toxin. But one of the primary reasons that they are delivered to us in a freeze-dried format is ease of transport and shelf life. And that requires us to dilute these toxins with the constituents. Some people use water injection, some people use normal saline, and others use bacteriostatic saline. And what that does, that allows us to choose which dilutant and choose the dilution or the concentration of which suits for clinical indication, clinical need, and location, and also our preference and perhaps our aesthetic preference as well. Relfydess, which is RELA botulinum toxin type A, comes from its own strain. The strain is closely guarded secret so far, and it is extracted in a liquid state, and it's maintained in a liquid state from extraction all the way through to delivery to our clinics. And that's through a process called the Pearl process, which I will explain later on in this video. So let's discuss the main clinical differences which have been identified in the initial studies. And they have been onset of action and duration of effect. There may also be some differences in the diffusion, but more studies have to come out for that. So we know already that Botox on a botulinum toxin takes about 3 to 5 days to start activity in most patients and tends to peak anywhere between 2 and 3 weeks. We know that with Eluzience, which is the liquid-only form of ABO botulinum toxin, also known as Dysport, can have an onset of action at about 2 to 3 days, with about 90% of people reaching peak effect at about a week. Dr. Sachin Shridharani from New York led the ReDy1 study, which showed that 39% of patients responded to the RELA botulinum toxin within 24 hours of their first injection, which is very impressive and significantly quicker than any of the other forms of botulinum toxin type A available to us. So that's really interesting. And from the colleagues who've been lucky enough to get their hands on this toxin in Spain, Germany, and France, they have absolutely communicated to me that this is quite true. Next, there's the duration of effect. We know that Botox typically lasts between 3 or 4 months, or Dysport or ABO botulinum toxin can last between 4 to 5 months. What's fascinating about the ReDy1 and ReDy4 studies is that they've shown that at 6 months, 75% of patients still haven't returned to baseline. And that is a significant increase in duration of effect of their toxin treatment. And this was two areas such as the glabella and the lateral canthal lines. Next, let's talk about the diffusion properties. We know that there are some slight differences in their field of effect between onobotulinum toxin and abobotulinum toxin. And we use those to their benefits, really, depending on the indication. What Dressler identified was that they showed that if you've got no complexin proteins, the field of effect may well be less. And with relabotulinum toxin or Relfydess, because there are no complexin proteins, we expect the field of effect to be smaller than those toxins with complexin proteins. The Pearl process is Galderma's proprietary manufacturing process that sets Relfydess or relabotulinum toxin apart from all the other types of toxin. It's the Pearl process that preserves the integrity of the toxin molecule. It preserves its liquid state, removes the complexin proteins, which lowers the risk of immunogenicity. There is enhanced molecule stability. Now, this has been shown in studies to be significantly higher than any of the other forms of toxin extraction processes. And this ensures a much higher stability in the molecule, and therefore we are much more likely to get a higher level of consistency in results with our patient. The Relfydess vial is diluted to about 1.5 mils. There is a fixed number of toxin units in there, and this allows consistent and more precise dosing when administering to our patients. And that brings me on to the Relfydess volumetric dosing method. If we think about how we prepare our toxins now, if you're using abobotulinum toxin, or in the UK, Azulur, you'll be perhaps using 0.63 mils of bacteriostatic saline injected into a vial. Now, several things can affect the clinical efficacy of that vial. First of all, the storage of that vial. What temperature? Have you been moving it in and out of the room temperature back to the fridge? That will reduce the integrity of the active toxin. Two, have you shaken the vial a bit too hard? That will potentially damage the toxin. Three, how fast was the water or the saline injected into the vial? Too fast could potentially damage the toxin. Four, how fast did you inject it into the patient? Again, that could reduce the viability. If you think about it, if you've injected 0.63 mils, sometimes you might inject 0.65 or 0.61 when drawing up this volume, because we do this so frequently. Those small differences can have an impact on the dose and the strength that you've applied to the patient. So with the volumetric dosing, we know exactly how many units are in there. And so all we have to worry about is how much volume we inject into a patient, and that we will know the exact dose we've given. So this is going to deliver much more consistent clinical results to our patients, happier patients, and therefore they're more likely to return to our practice. So if this botulinum toxin, so Relfydess, does last 6 months or so, how is that going to impact clinical practice? How is that going to impact our patients' satisfaction rates? I've got a few thoughts about that. First of all, if all goes well, it's brilliant for your patients, okay? Our patients can come to our practice less frequently. I don't know about you, but my patients who I ask to come at every about 4 months try to stretch it to 5 to 6, and you look at them when they arrive and they should have come a month or two ago. I'm hoping that if Relfydess does last longer, that those patients will come every 6 months rather than stretching that out to 7 or 8 months. But at least I know that they're going to have a better clinical effect, and that the cumulative effect over years will produce the desired results. There's a concern that people coming less to your practice may reduce the amount of business coming through your practice. We just have to wait and see. For me, if you've got happy patients, they're more likely to talk about you and come back to your practice, and that's all that matters to me. Doing what's right for your patients is key. Let the rest of it look after itself. And finally, what's really interesting is that we all have some patients that perhaps aren't getting the longevity from their toxins that they used to. Maybe they're developing a little bit of immunogenicity, some resistance towards their whole strain of toxin. And switching over to a whole new strain of toxin in Relfydess, in Rella botulinum toxin, may help those patients enjoy the benefits of botulinum toxin. So that's my summary of the benefits or that I'm understanding, and also the questions that remain unanswered about Rella botulinum toxin or Relfydess, how it compares to Botox. And look, if you've got any questions, please post them in the comments below. I'll answer them myself personally, and I'm also available for any training. Just contact the clinic and I'll be more than happy to see you and show you how to use this product.